All right, guys, let's talk about solving a linear inequality. All right, this should relate directly to the amazing race, and what I've seen so far is you guys have a pretty good grasp on these, but let's go over some details. All right, two keys to solving linear inequalities correctly. One is you are basically going to solve as if you are solving a linear equation. Okay, so you guys should be very good at these at this point. This goes back to the very first homework. So again, it's going to be like solving the linear equation. All right, so 2x equals 4. We know how to solve that. Divide both sides by 2. Versus 2x less than or equal to 4. We're going to solve it the same darn way. We're going to divide both sides by 2. Okay, the difference is in the answer. With the equation, we get one answer, x equals 2. Whereas with the inequality, we get an interval, x less than or equal to 2. The other thing to keep in mind is that we always have to reverse the direction of the inequality symbol when multiplying or dividing by a negative number. All right, and I've tried to always include examples where this may come up. All right, but again, keep that in mind that we've got to reverse the direction of the inequality when multiplying or dividing by a negative number. All right, what do I mean by solve like a linear equation? Well, we need to simplify each side. And then we need to get the variable terms on one side and constant terms on the other. All right, so again, I'm giving you guys a recipe here, and I'm hoping that your brain is going, hey, wait a minute, this sounds exactly like it did in the very first lecture when we were talking about linear equations. And that's exactly what I mean by that. We simplify each side, we get the x terms on one side, we get the numbers or constant terms on the other, we isolate the variable and solve. Then we're going to graph the solution set on a number line. So 4 is the only step where we're different than solving the linear equation. Instead of having our one solution, we're now going to graph the solution set on a number line. And then we're going to use that graph to write the solution set in set builder or interval notation. In particular, on the exam, I'm not going to be terribly picky. I will ask you to graph it on a number line, and then I'll just say express it also in set builder or interval notation. Whereas in my math lab in the homework, it's going to be a little bit more specific. All right, so let's solve and graph the solution set for this inequality. 3x plus 1 greater than 7x minus 15. Well, the first thing I need to do is subtract 1 from each side, meaning move the 1 to the right side. That gives me 3x greater than 7x minus 16. The next thing I want to do is move that 7x. And so how am I going to do that? I'm subtracting 7x from both sides, giving me negative 4x greater than negative 16. Well, just like with the linear equation, I want to get the x by itself. So that means I need to divide both sides by negative 4. But wait a minute, we're dividing by negative 4. So since it's negative, we have to flip that inequality. And so I have x now less than 4. Okay, so let's think about graphing that. I put my parentheses on 4 and I graph everything to the left. All right, so every x less than 4. All right, how would I go about writing this? Well, in set builder notation, that's the set of all x such that x is less than 4. Or we can say with using parentheses, parentheses negative infinity, comma 4 parentheses. All right, what about inequalities with unusual solution sets? What the heck do I mean by unusual solution sets? Well, some inequalities are never true. For example, x greater than x plus 1. All right, how could a number ever be greater than itself plus 1? That doesn't even make sense. Okay, and so in a situation like this, the solution set is the null set or the empty set. All right. And then on the flip side, some inequalities are always true. Like a number is always going to be less than itself plus 1. All right, and so for an example like this, the solution set is all real numbers. So sometimes we'll see the capital R, or we can think of it as negative infinity to infinity. All right, let's look at this example. Solve the inequality. Okay, well, I have 3 times some parentheses greater than 3x plus 2. Guys, let's think, if this were a linear equation, what would I do? Most certainly, I would distribute the 3 on the left first, get rid of parentheses. So I have 3x plus 3 greater than 3x plus 2. Okay, well, maybe ask yourself this. When is 3x plus 3 greater than 3x plus 2? I don't know. I don't know yet. That just seems a little weird to me, though. Well, let's subtract 3x from both sides. No big deal. I subtract 3x from both sides, and now I have 3 greater than 2. Well, how about now? When is 3 greater than 2? If I have $3 and you have 2, who's richer? Well, that would be me, because 3 is always greater than 2, right? Yes, the solution is always, or negative infinity to infinity. All right, let's try this one. Let's solve the inequality, x plus 1 less than x minus 1. Well, let's subtract x from both sides. Let's move the x. But when is x plus 1 less than x minus 1? Sounds a little fishy, huh? Well, let's go ahead and do that arithmetic. The x's actually cancel, so I get 1 less than negative 1. When in the world is 1 less than negative 1? That sounds ridiculous, all right? And so hopefully you're going, never, all right? Like Simon Cowell here, giving his thumbs down. Or we can call this the empty set or the null set, and that is our circle with the bar through it.